नित्यानन्देश्वर परम शिव समारम्भाम् नित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्तिमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, shrimahans, mahans, tanidar, kotaris, visitors, viewers, sitting with us through Nityananda TV, YouTube Live, Facebook Live, Enlighten App, Kailasa TV, Hinduism Now TV, Twitter and two-way video conferencing having Nayanadiksha. I welcome all the Nityananda Yogam participants, Kayakalpa Yoga participants, e-Gurukul students and everyone sitting with us with my love and respects. Today, 7th day of the Avatara Dina Brahmotsava and Utsava Murti of Bhagavan Shri Nityananda Paramashivam is adorned with the Leela Alankara of Devi Meenakshi Parashakti learning all the 64 vidyas, 64 kalas, and let's first offer our devotion and respects and receive the grace.
अथ धूपः ॐ धूरसि धूर्वधूर्वन्तं धूर्वतयोऽस्मान् धूर्वदितं धूर्वयं वयं धूर्वामस्त्वं देवानामसि सत्नितमं वपृतमं जुष्टतमं वह्नितमं देवहूतममृतमसि अवृत्तानं दृगुंहस्वमाह्वामित्रस्य त्वाचक्षुषा प्रेक्षेर्माभिर्मासं दिक्थामात्वा हि गुंशिषम् सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्रीनित्यानन्द परमशिवाय नमः। धूपमाग्रापयामि ॐ उत्तीप्यस्वजातवेदोपघ्नं निररिदिं मम पशुगुश्चमह्यमावह जीवनं च दिशो दश मानो हि गुंसीर्जातवेदो गामस्वं पुरुषं जगत् अभिद्रदग्न आगहि श्रिया मा परिपातय। सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्रीनित्यानन्द परमशिवाय नमः। दीपं दर्शयामि ॐ मधुवातारतायते मधुक्षरन्ति सिन्धवः माध्वीर्नः सन्तोषधी मधुनक्तमुत्तोषसि मधुमत्पार्थिवगुं रजः मधुद्योरस्तु नः पिता मधुमान्नो वनस्पतिर्मधुमागुम् अस्तु सूर्यः माध्वीर्गावो भवन्तु नः मधु मधु मधु। सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्रीनित्यानन्द परमशिवाय नमः। नैवेद्यं निवेदयामि ॐ सोमो वा एतस्य राज्यमाधत्ते यो राजा सन् राज्यो वा सोमेन यजते देवसु वा मेधानि हवीगुंसि भवन्ति एतावन्तो वै देवानागुंसवाः त एवास्मै सवान् प्रयच्छन्ति तेन पुनः सुवन्ते राज्याय देवसु राजा भवति। कर्पूरगौरं करुणावतारं संसारसारं भुजगेन्द्रहारं सदा वसन्तं हृदयारविन्दे भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि। सर्वदेव देवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः। कर्पूर नीराजनं संदर्शयामि।
Listen, deluded people always believe others are deluded. Listen carefully. Deluded people always believe others are deluded. And most funny thing, the same argument even the abusers use against me and the Sangha. Listen carefully. I am saying this as a message from Kailasa. Deluded people believe others are deluded. And the most funny thing, the abusers use the same argument against me. Listen carefully. I'll repeat. I'll explain now. How to find out whether somebody is deluded or not? Listen. Whoever is constantly inspiring, working, contributing to others' life, raising everyone's quality of consciousness, day in and day out, who is doing the job of liberating people, enlightening people, he is the one not deluded. Understand? Meena Joshi? Attention, Meena Joshi. If Meena Joshi is online, please come on two-way video conferencing. I saw some of your posts and I'll respond to you. Listen first. You put a post that it's truism. That if there is a smoke, there is a fire, and I think some post. First thing you need to understand, there is no fire here, there is no smoke here. It is smog, neither smoke nor fire. Understand that. The attack going on now is more lies than 2010. The earlier attacks. There is neither fire nor smoke. The idea of fire is generated. Idea of smoke is generated through smog. Understand, this time this attack has no substance. It neither has fire nor has smoke. It's absolute smog. Just wait for 1 or 2 days, it will settle down. Please understand, sometimes I am not directly attending to people and their doubts, questions. Why, you know? Because they are waiting to get hurt. Understand one thing. See, you look at somebody with a lot of respect, reverence, and you build trust, devotion. Somebody comes and somehow puts some heavy lies continuously, doubts, and shakes you, shakes even the way you perceive you, and disturbs you, and you start looking at the same person with less reverence, less respect. You are completely shaken. You see, understand. It is too easy to trigger somebody's doubt. And maybe, who knows? Yes. Somebody's hatred, denial, anger, when that is triggered, they feel that they have been cheated. In that, too many emotions comes up, anger, frustration. They themselves are not able to handle themselves. At that time, at those times, they are waiting to get hurt. Any word I utter, they will pick up that word and hurt themselves more. See, if I show confidence, they'll say, "Hey, see how arrogant he is. He has no sensitivity for my feelings, my emotion. I am not treated respectfully, responsibly." If I show humbleness, see, he has collapsed. We know he has done the crime. That is why he has collapsed. He is fed up. He is frustrated. He is not able to handle himself. He is mentally broken. Understand. People will have their own theories. They may have theories even for this table. Why suddenly this table? Understand? This is the way traditionally the sannidhanams in Adinams sit. So this is the usual way I sit and read. Today I thought, let me have that table, that's all, nothing else. That is why before the satsang started, I gave full darshan to show that I am completely all right, well and healthy, hale and healthy. All my body parts are hale and healthy. I am fully alive and active. Then put the table for satsang. See, people are waiting to get hurt. Listen, when they are waiting to get hurt, even a small word from me, they will make their own meaning. And they will hurt themselves more. When they hurt themselves more, they turn their anger to me. Understand? When the guru doubt, guru hatred, guru denial is generated, it turns as self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial. And when the self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial is generated, it turns as guru doubt, guru hatred, guru denial. Understand? People don't understand the difference between a doctor and butcher. Both may have knife in their hand. I am a doctor. I am not butcher. Please understand. When people are waiting to get hurt, angry, frustrated, doubtful, having mood swings, the best solution is have little patience. Wait for them to settle down. When they are in the space to listen, start explaining and make them understand. Meena Joshi, that is the reason sometimes I keep quiet. I do not respond to people directly. I wait. I can see last 15 days itself, so many people have slowly settled down and started coming to the space of listening. They started connecting. So now I am sending clear understandings and clear powerful cognitions and right messages to them. Please understand. I am dealing with millions of people and evolving them to different levels. It is not a joke to be Nityananda. Understand? I tell you, anyone who is ready to take the responsibility, I am very happy to give. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ జోక్ టు బి నిత్యానంద. జస్ట్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ పరమశివాస్ గ్రేస్ ఐఎమ్ స్టిల్ అలైవ్. జస్ట్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ మహాకాల భైరవాస్ ప్రొటెక్షన్ ఐఎమ్ స్టిల్ అలైవ్. సంగా ఈజ్ స్టిల్ సర్వైవింగ్. ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ నాట్ జస్ట్ సర్వైవింగ్, ఫ్లరిషింగ్, స్ప్రెడింగ్. అండర్స్టాండ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ టూ మచ్ ఆఫ్ వర్క్ అండ్ రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ అబౌట్ ఎవ్రీ పర్సన్. ఐ టెల్ యూ హౌ. See, I have seen the people, the extreme devotees, as I said many times, people who are ready to give up their life just for me to have a cup of coffee. Same way, extreme traitors, people who are ready to sell me or kill me just for them to have a morning cup of coffee, cup of tea. Even if it is HET, it's okay for them. Understand, I have seen all kinds of people. I tell you how these deluded traitors behave. First, when I give a vision, they deludedly assume that it is a promise given to them and not only never take up the responsibility which they need to do from their side to fulfill the vision. They think they will sit in a palki, the golden palki, and I will have to carry the whole palki and put them in the goal. Understand? Okay, I am ready to even to do that, but when I carry the palki and put them in the goal, they destroy the kingdom given to them and then come back and tell nobody is listening to me. You come and make all of them listen to me. Neither they take the responsibility nor they will do anything creative. They will just use me and bully everyone and destroy everyone. Abuse, destroy the Sangha using me. And I also have little patience. And okay, this is the way people will evolve. This is the way people will evolve. Okay. Here thousands come, thousands live. So people will understand one by one. One day they will evolve. But my patience, they mistake as I need them. And then they try to strategically praise me. Appa. I am afraid of only one thing. These poisonous people strategically trying to praise me. And they think I'll be deluded by it. The moment they move out, I'll say, oh God, hey. Chakradada. Understand? And then they build continuously their delusion that they are too important. And they try to form their own gang. And they know how to form power center and who all should be in their control. And they have multiple methodologies to control people. Using the fear and greed of people. And exploiting the innocent and cheating. Understand one thing. And so cunningly they will use my name. Even now, I have not authorized anyone to speak on my behalf in media. No spokesperson. Because people who want to hurt the Sangha first try to become my spokesperson. So that once they get a little seal or authority, then they can run riot, ruin. Understand. deluded people too much of delusion and they strongly believe they have deluded me. That is the most funny thing. And I do not know, I am unaware of what is going on and all that. I just smile and okay. When you feel that I should not know something, I also behave as if I don't know that. Let's, okay. Understand one thing. You play with the child, expecting that one day child will evolve and support. My compassion, they mistake it as my ignorance. Listen, many of these people, abusers, deluded people, they mistake my compassion for my ignorance. Understand? I let all kinds of people grow, evolve. I am telling you various levels from which how people become abusers or plan conspiracies, how the traitors, prisons, conspirators, abusers evolve. I am giving you the psychology in multi-level. Because they are deluded with fear and greed, they think they can delude me with fear and greed. And they try to spread all funny things. First thing I want to tell, I am going to give lot of detailed multi-level explanations about multiple lies being spread, abuses being spread. One thing, they talk about the mandala, all our mandalas, they try to tell, hey, there is some black magic, mind controlling through mandala. Hey, understand first thing, all these mandalas are done absolutely as per Vedagamas. What is the content in the mandala? See, Mahameru, Sri Chakra. Can anyone put black magic energy into the Sri Chakra? It is Parashakti. Paramashiva's photo is there. Parashakti's mandala is there. The yantras used, just see the yantras, Ashtalakshmi, Hindu gods and goddesses, Navagrahas, Hindu gods and goddesses. Can anyone put black magic energy into Hindu gods and goddesses? Understand. No one can put black magic energy into Rudraksha or Kantamala. Kantamala as a Rudraksha. Nobody, it is a Paramashiva's eyes, third eye. How can anybody put black magic energy into Rudraksha? How can anybody put black magic energy into Sri Mandala, Sri Chakra? How can anybody put black magic energy into Navagraha Yantras? It is all, see those mandalas, the yantras are all not printed by us. It is all printed in a regular Hindu items production shops. Those tapatis made it. And it is brought only energized by me. Understand. Mandalas are powerful deities. They protect you from all black magic. People who want to destroy you, turn you away from me, take you away from Kalabhairava's protection, Paramashiva's protection, they cannot enter your space. That is why they force you to remove Kantamala and force you to remove all the mandalas so that they can have influence over you. Understand. Hindu deities cannot be filled by black magic energy. Understand that fundamentally. All the mandalas I have given you, is all absolutely done as per Vedagamic tradition, including the color threads are done as per the Vedagamic tradition. I can give you all original verses, how it is done. You can see the content of the mandalas, the Kurma mandala, or the Bhuvaneshwari mandala, Bhuvana mandala, Brahmanda Yoni mandala, Shri Yantra, Guru mandala. See all of that. It is absolute Sri Chakra, Mahameru. Can anyone fill black magic energy into Mahameru? What kind of a lie spread? Please be very clear. Those mandalas, Kantamala is protecting you from the black magic and negative energy of the abusers. Listen, abusers are the negative people. You see, what they want? They just want to destroy your trust and faith and devotion, integrity to Paramashiva. That's all. After that, do they have any other alternative for you? No. They just want to destroy you. That's it. Every practice I have given you, whether applying vibhuti or kumkum or jnananjana, everything is directly from Vedagamic tradition. And I want to tell you, jnananjana, Arunachaleshwara temple, the Kartikeya Deepam, that anjana is mixed always in jnananjana. See that in Arunachaleshwara temple, they light the deepam on the top of the hill. That in that, from that deepam, the anjana comes. That anjana is given as a prasadam. So that is the tradition from which I make this jnananjana. Because we will not get that in large quantity, we do it on our own. But we always mix that. Understand. How can anybody add black magic energy into Arunachaleshwara temple's Deepa Jnananjana? Now I tell you, if you don't want to use my Jnananjana, use Arunachaleshwara temple Deepa Jnananjana, you will manifest powers. Chant Mahavagya. And use that Jnananjana, you will manifest powers. Abusers may not know who I am. But all of you and me, my disciples and me, all of us know I am Arunachala. So Arunachaleshwara temple, vibhuti, Arunachaleshwara hill, on the hill, top of the hill, they light the Mahadeepam, that Jnananjanam. Take it and apply and chant Mahavagya, you will manifest powers. You want to say, in that black magic is, energy is added. I want to tell all devotees, disciples, understand, as long as mandalas are there with you, Kantamala is there with you, these negative people and their black magic energy cannot work on you. That is why they insist and forcibly remove that from you. And I tell you, whatever they give to with their energy, you keep that along with mandalas, and whatever mala they give, you wear that, their beads, everything. Let's see whose kantamala is powerful or their beads are powerful. My mandala is powerful or their mandala is powerful. You keep both, I don't have a problem. But they don't want you to keep my kantamala and my mandalas. Why? Because they know it is too powerful. Now it's open challenge. If somebody tells you, any all our devotees, listen, if somebody tells you, remove kantamala, remove all the mandalas, you tell them, you give yours, I'll wear that also. See, if they tell, oh, through kantamala, through mandalas only, Swamiji is controlling. Oh, okay. You give yours for me not to get influenced by Swamiji. I'll wear that. I'll keep that mandala. Come on. Let me see which one works. Do not remove kantamala or mandalas. If you remove, you are gone. They will get him inside immediately and destroy your whole spiritual possibility. If they want to protect you from my negative influence, then they should give their items. That's all. But they insist on you removing all these items so that their negativity can influence you. Understand one thing. Do one thing. If you feel little doubt, maybe through this kantamala, through this mandala, Swamiji is controlling me. Do one thing. Get Arunachaleshwara temple vibhuti, get Meenakshi's kumkum, and get Arunachaleshwara deepam jnananjanam, and put all that on, all the mandalas I have given, all the kantamala I have given, put that on all of it. Can any negative energy, black magic energy stay even after Paramashiva's vibhuti and Parashakti's kumkum and Paramashiva's jnananjana? That's all. That solves the whole matter. Understand, if somebody is telling you, oh, kantamala has negativity, black magic, and mandala yantras have all black magic, you tell them, okay, now I am bringing Arunachaleshwara's vibhuti, Parashakti, Meenakshi's kumkum, Arunachaleshwara's jnananjana, and spreading it on all this. Can any black magic energy stay even beyond Arunachaleshwara's vibhuti and kumkum and jnananjana? I tell you, the moment you remove kantamala and mandalas, gone. Their devil, black magic energy can enter and destroy you. That is what they are doing. They are brainwashing you against Hinduism. They are brainwashing you against the divine protection. And they are destroying you. Understand that. So now I am very clearly telling you, clear standard method to check whether what I am giving is pure Vedagamic tradition or black magic. I am giving you clear method. Get any temple prasadam from any Hindu temple. Arunachaleshwara temple, Meenakshi temple, Venkateshwara Balaji, Tirupati Balaji Venkateshwara temple, from any of this traditional Vedagamic temple, bring the prasadam. Vishwanatha, Kashi Vishwanatha temple, bring the prasadam. Bring Ganga water. Sprinkle, apply. Can any black magic stay after that? No. Tell them, any abusers tell you this, oh, through kantamala, through the mandalas, some black magic, Swamiji is controlling you. You tell them, no, I have brought temple prasadam and sprinkled on it. And I have applied that on kantamala. And I know there is no black magic, negative energy in this. I'll take care of myself, don't worry. Understand, these are the open time-tested methods. This is so simple. I tell you, they know as long as kantamala is there, mandalas are there, you are protected. Even if you have a mental mood swing, your consciousness will come back to the higher frequency and you can be connected back to Paramashiva and you will come back to completion. They do not want that. They want to destroy you once for all. Understand? That is why they insist on remove kantamala, remove mandalas. I tell you, even if you have a doubt, maybe in my photograph, I have kept some negative energy and controlling. Okay, you remove all my photographs. No problem. You remove my photograph from the kantamala, no problem. Wear the rudraksha. You remove my photograph from mandalas and keep the mandala. You will understand. ఇట్ ఈస్ ప్యూర్ వేదాగమిక్ స్పిరిచువల్ ఎనర్జీ. ఐ టెల్ యూ, వెన్ యూ రిమూవ్ ద కంఠమాల, వెన్ యూ రిమూవ్ ద మండలాస్, యూ కెన్ బి ఈజీలీ యూస్డ్ బై నెగటివ్ ఎనర్జీస్, బ్లాక్ మ్యాజిక్ పీపుల్ అగెయిన్స్ట్ ద స్పిరిచువల్ ఎన్లైటన్మెంట్ సైన్స్. అండర్స్టాండ్ వన్ థింగ్, వాట్ ఐఎమ్ డూయింగ్ ఈస్ అబ్సల్యూట్ Vedagamic tradition. That is why every word I am uttering is Paramashiva. Hey, to whom I am asking you to connect with? Paramashiva, the form clearly described in Vedas and Agamas. I have already released the Dhyana Sloka. As he is describing himself, actually the Paramashiva we are showing you, 50 hands and 25 heads and 75 eyes. It is a self-portrait of Paramashiva. He himself describes himself in Agamas, how he is. That's exactly what we are presenting it to you. Mahasadashiva, the ultimate form of Paramashiva. See, Paramashiva is formlessness, beyond form and formlessness. The ultimate form is this. This form of 25 heads and 50 hands and 75 eyes, this Mahasadashiva form. Understand that. I am absolute Hindu Vedagamic principles. There is nothing black magic about it. I am neither black magic nor white magic. I am not magic. I am golden miracle from Kailasa, Sri Kailasa. Understand that. I am neither white magic nor black magic. I am not magic at all. I am a miracle, golden miracle from Sri Kailasa. Every this kind of questions, dissent ideas, incompletions you hear, bring it. I will deal with utmost love, compassion, completion. Help everyone to achieve completion. See, fundamentally, I am a completion-based organization. I am interested only in the space of completion, helping everyone to achieve completion. But I will not bend for blackmailing or extortion. You see, many people can't understand. People have, see, when many people, when they come into the Sangha, first thing they look how to grab this throne. They neither want to work nor want to take responsibility for enlightenment. They just want somehow to grab this throne. They try to be like a Bhasmasura. How I can get boon from Paramashiva and try to grab this place, grab this throne. Actually, many innocent devotees don't understand this abusers, traitors, treasons. They have extreme greed. They try to tell, you are not here, na? So let me have this throne. They don't understand. They neither understand enlightenment nor want to take the responsibility for enlightenment. They just want to grab. And they use the innocent devotees. And funny thing, they make the devotees feel that they have been brainwashed. Understand, this is the scale to find out. Who is contributing to the humanity continuously, evolving, raising consciousness, working for Sanatana Hindu Dharma, working to enrich the world with Sanatana Hindu Dharma. Understand? You can see very clearly how continuously last 41 years, I think now 42 years almost, only few more days, with the grace of Paramashiva, I got enriched by my gurus and I started enriching. That's all is my life. Understand, every person who is ready to come with Kankal with you, we can give them the answers for their concerns, for their incompletions, for their questions, for their doubts. Because I trust you and I trust your integrity to me and I trust your commitment to me. But somebody is trying to destroy Sangha or destroy, even thinking of destroying me, we can't do anything. We can't do anything. We will have to just protect ourselves. We will have to defend ourselves. That's a natural way. We will have to defend the Sangha. Understand? I have seen how the traitors attack the people who are integrated and try to shake them step by step and make them do the U-turn. Here we are only to spread Sanatana Hindu Dharma, to give completion and to give spiritual solution, and we are waiting to do that. We will be happy to do that. And Meena Joshi also put one more post, that Caesar playing, I think, I don't know that, I did not fully read that. Caesar playing some Rome burning, all that you put, I don't know whether Nero fiddled while Rome burnt or Caesar, you put that post. I want to tell you, I am representative of Paramashiva. I am neither Caesar nor Nero. I am representative of Paramashiva. And Kailasa is not burning. There is neither smoke nor fire. It's only fog. Smog and fog. Smog looks like smoke. The people create smog and try to make it look like smoke and then say, hey, if there is a smoke, there is a fire. There is only smog. There is no smoke and there is no fire. It's only fog. Looks like smog. That's all. And it is a passing cloud. All we need to do is have little patience and let people settle down, let things cool down. Time heals everything. Then make them understand one by one. Just this one point, make them understand. You see, if you have been asked to remove Kantamala and throw away the mandalas, this one challenge, Kantamala challenge, mandala challenge, get the traditional temple, Hindu agamic temples, Prasada, Vibhuti and Kumkum, and spread it on mandala and Kantamala and wear it. Can any negative energy, black magic energy, continue to hide inside after the temple prasadam is put on it? In mandala or on Kantamala? No. Understand. Bring prasadam from Arunachalishwara temple. Bring prasadam from Meenakshi temple. Bring prasadam from Arunachalishwara temple Jnananjana and put all that on mandala and Kantamala. It will work more intensely, more powerfully. I am teaching pure Hinduism. No black magic. Pure Hinduism. I am chanting Vedas, Upanishads, Agamas, When I conduct process, what is the mantras I chant? Do I chant damal dumil dum tak dum? No. Simple Vedas and Agamas and straight Upanishads. That's what I am chanting. How can anyone infuse black magic energy, negative energy into Upanishad mantras? What is the mantra I am chanting while I am asking you to meditate? Satyo jatam pravatyami, satyo jata yavai namo namaha. Can anybody infuse black magic energy into this vibration? What is the mandalas I have given you? Sri Chakra. Navagraha Yantras. Ashtalakshmi Yantras. See all the mandalas inside. Can anybody infuse black magic energy into Navagrahas? Can anybody infuse black magic energy into Ashtalakshmi? Can anybody infuse black magic energy into Parashakti? Mahameru is Parashakti. Can anybody infuse black magic energy into Kalabhairava Mandala? Kalabhairava, Paramashiva. Take this one challenge. Tell those abusers, actually people who are doing, these abusers are doing black magic and negative energy. That is why they are asking you, remove Kantamala, remove Mandala, so that they can have influence over you. Till you remove Kantamala and Mandalas, they cannot have their negative influence over you. They cannot use you. They cannot hypnotize you. They cannot mesmerize you. They cannot possess you. They cannot mentally control you, because you will be protected by Kalabhairava. You will have the consciousness. Understand, I tell you, mandalas, Kantamala is the absolute protection from Paramashiva and Mahakalabhairava. Do one thing. If you have a doubt, as I said, go to any of these traditional temples, Hindu temples. Arunachaleshwara Temple, Madurai Meenakshi Temple, Tirupati Venkateshwara Temple, Ujjaini Mahakal Temple, Kashi Vishwanath Temple, Kashi Kalabhairava Temple, Kashi Annapurna Temple, all the 12 Jyotirlingas, Vishwanatha, Ramanatha, Ujjaini Mahakala, go to all these temples and bring any of these temples prasadam and put it. And the mandalas, Samayapuram Mariamman, go to Samayapuram temple and get the kumkumam and put it on all the mandalas and put it on the Kantamala. Can any negative energy, black magic energy stand after this prasadam is put? That's all. That's all I am saying. If people are brainwashing you through Kantamala and Jnananjana and mandalas, somebody can put negative energy and do mind control. They are cheating you and exploiting you. Understand? If somebody can fill energy, their energy into Sri Chakra, it can only be Parashakti. Nobody else. Nobody else can fill the energy in Sri Chakra other than Parashakti. Nobody else can fill the Mahakalabhairava Yantra with energy other than Mahakalabhairava himself. Nobody can fill the energy in Navagraha Mandala other than Navagrahas themselves. Nobody can fill the energy in Ashtalakshmi Mandala other than Ashtalakshmis themselves. Just this simple challenge, simple argument, whole problem is solved. Don't you understand? All our temples, 99% are complete Hindu traditional deities. Only one deity will be mine, or one or two. Just count. Mahaganapati. Can anybody feel negative energy or black magic energy into Mahaganapati? What are you talking? Can anybody feel black magic energy into 63 Nayanmars? And Muruga? And Parashakti? Meenakshi? Rajarajeshwari? Paramashiva? What is going on? Don't you guys understand? The abusers are really playing with negative energies and destroying your spiritual growth. First they remove the spiritual protection you have, and then they destroy you, control you, abuse you, mentally manipulate you, use you for their ulterior motives. Understand? Which side you move, that is going to be deciding your future. You should decide now whether you are going to be moved to Paramashiva's side, or understand whether you are going to move to Paramashiva's side and connect with Sri Kailasa, or you are going to move to the negative demonic Rakshasa's side. You decide. I am absolutely clear. I teach traditional, time-tested, foolproof Veda Agamic tradition. There is nothing other than Veda Agamic tradition in my teachings. Including how many number of jatas you should have, how you should apply vibhuti, everything is directly from Vedas and Agamas. We can give you original verses. Already we have released all this. And all the mandalas and the original verses are also already released. Whatever we have not released, we can even, if you ask, we will release. If it is not available in the public platform. Even the food you are supposed to eat, the Bhagashastra, all the original sutras we already collected and released. Original book is released. I am only reviver. I am only reviver. I am only reviver. How can Dakshinamurti Mandala, Dakshinamurti Yantra be infused by any black magic energy? When people try to come and brainwash you, ask them all these questions. Tell them, expose them to them, who is brainwashed? In every level, every question we have answers. Meena Joshi, I am not answering many of the other things in the open platform because I don't want people who are waiting to get hurt pick up these words and hurt themselves. But anyone who comes through you, with all my integrity to Paramashiva, I assure, with the grace of Paramashiva, blessings of Mahakala Bhairava, we will handle with deep love, compassion, completion, friendliness, and try to present all the truths and help them to achieve completion. We are here for spiritual purpose, and we will continue to do spiritual work. I have seen, I tell you, these abusers, traitors, prisons, they try to grab Sangha, try to grab the Sangha wealth and destroy Sangha for their selfish desires, their motives. I protected Sangha, Sangha wealth, hard earned money donated by devotees from these traitors and treasons. That is why they are attacking me. Understand that. Understand that. I'll be true to every penny given by devotees, disciples, and I'll keep my integrity and the integrity of the Sangha all over the world. We will keep our spiritual integrity to Paramashiva and Vedagamic traditions, and we are protected by Paramashiva and Mahakala Bhairava. Mahakala Bhairava is protecting me and the Sangha. Understand? Actually, this time they are using huge more lies than 2010 or earlier attacks. I should say this time almost absolute lies. You can see very clearly in few days the whole smog will settle down, whole fog will settle down. Then you will realize there is neither smoke nor fire. When there is a fog, smog, even you cannot see yourself. Even you get deluded about you. So during these times, I tell you, during these times, coming with your crowbar outside and standing in the road and fighting, hey, I will fight with this smog, I will fight with this fog. Just sit silently and keep your strong feeling connection, devotion, commitment to Paramashiva and Guru alive. Do spiritual practice. Get more and more integrated. If you can, enrich people who are not deluded. Don't even try to go and argue with the people who are already deluded, because they will somehow put the poison in you. See, when they tell 10,000 things, you may start thinking, maybe 2 is true. That's the way they try to make smog and fog look like a smoke, and then once you feel there is a smoke, then they convince you there must be fire. And then once they convince you there is a fire, they will tell you run, 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 there is fire. And then you will be running, frightened by the smog and fog, thinking there is a smoke and fire, and in that smog and fog, when you run, you hit and make accidents for yourself and destroy yourself. This is the way the life negative people work. Understand? I have seen enough. I tell you, with all my spiritual love for you, keep your integrity with Paramashiva and Guru intact. Keep Kantamala and Mandalas as your protection. You will have Kala Bhairava's protection, Paramashiva's blessings. Even if you are little, you wavered and got pushed by those brainwashers, abusers, negative people, come back. Kailasa is open, waiting for you. Don't get lost. Enough. Come back. Kailasa is open for you. Understand? During this time, don't believe anything. Sometimes even about devotees, they create rumors. Oh, that devotee left. Then immediately you start reacting. That fellow says, hey, I have not done anything. Why are you hitting at me? Then he starts building insecurity. This is the way that abusers, the negative people, try to create conflict among the devotees, among the abusers. Abusers try to cause negativity among the devotees. So understand, do not fall for anything. Rumors, scandals, abuses. Fog and smog made to look like smoke and fire. Don't fall for any of it. Don't fall for any of it. Keep your integrity to Paramashiva and Guru alive. And continue the spiritual process, spiritual life. It'll all settle down. We will continue to do our work. So don't worry at all. Don't worry at all. We are continuing to build the golden temple in Bidhi, Adi Kailash. All the Sarvajnapita work continuously happening. And it will continue to happen and expand. I want to assure all devotees with the grace of Paramashiva and protection of Mahakala Bhairava, I am absolutely safe. Paramashiva is protecting me. Mahakala Bhairava is protecting me. Legally, politically, socially, spiritually, physically, in all levels, Paramashiva and Mahakala Bhairava is protecting me and the Sangha. Don't worry. And we have great work to do. We have a great mission to do. We have a great future to contribute. Understand? I am carrying two big message. Even I cannot destroy myself. I am like Chinnamasta. You know, in Hindu tradition, there is a deity called Chinnamasta. She cuts her own head. Even then, she is not dead. And she can't be dead. She is Parashakti. Even though she has cut her own head and holding it in one hand, she can't be killed. She can't be destroyed. She can't be destroyed even by herself. Same way, I can't be destroyed even by myself. Don't worry. I am carrying Paramashiva in me. Paramashiva is manifesting through me. And this Sangha is Paramashiva's work. Paramashiva and Mahakala Bhairava are directly manifesting through me and through this Sangha. And Paramashiva and Mahakala Bhairava is directly protecting me and the Sangha. Understand? Don't worry at all. So, just be relax in Paramashiva. Rest in Paramashiva. That's all. See, these people who are waiting to get hurt, when I show confidence, they feel, see how arrogant he is. If I am very humble, they feel, he has collapsed. What can I do? They are waiting to get hurt. They are just waiting for all this to create their own conclusions. So today's message, satsang message for all of you and for the whole world. I practice and stand for pure Veda Agamic tradition. Understand? I am ultimate grand narrative of Hinduism. I am integrated ultimate grand narrative of Hinduism. I practice Veda Agamic tradition and I stand for ultimate grand narrative of Hinduism. Paramashiva is real and Nityananda Sangha is Paramashiva's work and Sri Kailasa is Paramashiva himself manifesting. So I have a great news for all of you guys this time. In next few days, my Jayanti is coming, Avatara Dina Mahotsava is coming, birthday is coming. This time, anyone can do Pada Puja. There is no fixed donation. I am removing the tag. Even earlier, I was not okay, but Sangha was doing okay. But now, I am removing the tag. Anyone wants to offer Pada Puja on my birthday, you can send an email. You can offer just 1 rupee or 1 cent or 1 paise. I may say you don't need to offer anything, but Paramashiva insists when you do Pada Puja to Guru, you have to give some Guru Dakshina. It's because it is a Agamic, Vedagamic tradition. I tell you, at least give 1 paise or 1 penny or 1 cent or 1 rupee, something. Because it is a tradition to offer Guru Dakshina. Just because of that, you can offer 1 rupee or 1 crore rupee. You can offer $1 or $1 million. It's all up to you. Anybody wants, they can send an email and your name will be chanted in Sankalpa Mantra. But we may not be able to have dialed avatar calls because too many requests. But I'll accept all your love and accept your Pada Puja and send you my blessings, give you my blessings. And anyone wants, they can send the email for offering Pada Puja. I am making it more and more Vedagamic compliant. Making it more and more Vedagamic compliant. Even earlier it was only suggested donation. And it can continue to remain as a suggested donation. That's all. There is nothing wrong in having suggested donation. To sign up, kailasa.org/satsang. And now, I'll give you a few minutes. Any of you want to send an email requesting Pada Puja to be done in your name or in your family's name on Jayanti Day, please send the email now. And if you want to become e-Kailasavasi, please sign up now. Finish all that. I'll give you a few minutes, then I'll lead you into satsang. If you want to enrich somebody to sign up for e-Kailasavasi, or if you want to do it for yourself, if you want to send an email for doing Pada Puja for yourself and for your family or friends, or you want to enrich and you want to send on behalf of them, please send the, fill the forms, send the email to be e-Kailasavasi or to offer Pada Puja. Please finish that, then I'll lead you into process. The space of Sri Kailasa is real. Paramashiva is real. Sri Kailasa is real. Wherever Sri Kailasa, the space is imbibed and manifested, it starts happening in place also by the grace of Paramashiva and Parashakti. With the grace of Paramashiva, we are formally opening E Sri Kailasavasis to whole universe. It is a spiritual citizenship, becoming spiritual member of Kailas. You will get a lot of benefits, spiritual blessings and support, satsangs, messages from Sri Kailasa, Akashic reading sessions. I'll start answering your questions. You will receive special spiritual gifts, mandalas, nirahara samyama, lots of spiritual programs, classes. All the spiritual services Kailasa provides will be made available to all of you, and your prayers will be offered to Paramashiva directly, and you'll be blessed with the grace of Paramashiva and Parashakti. Everything the devotee of Paramashiva can expect from Paramashiva, you can expect all that by becoming E. Shri Kailasavasi, Kalabhairava's protection, Ganapati's blessings, Paramashiva's grace. To sign up, to become E. Shri Kailasavasis, Kailasa.org, E. Shri Kailasavasis. When each one of you become Paramashiva, wherever you are, that place becomes Shri Kailasa. Shri Kailasa is manifesting on Bhuloka with the grace of Paramashiva and Parashakti. You will all be able to experience physically on Bhuloka Shri Kailasa. So now, I'll start the process. Listen. Meditate on Paramashiva with 25 heads, 75 eyes, 50 hands, Parashakti in the lap. Connect with Shri Kailasa, space of Paramashiva. Chant the Mahavagya intensely. You will see Paramashiva manifests in all of us. Let's start.
Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Shiva. சிவனும் ஒன்றாகி நித்தியனாகி நின்றானே சக்தி என்னும் ரூபத்தை தரி
சிரசினை கொண்டு அந்தரும் சிவனே போற்றி ஆகிரம் கைகள் கொண்டு
நித்யா நித்யானந்தா சத்யா நித்ய ரூபா கண் கொண்டு பார்த்தீர்ப்பாய் மனிதன் அவளும் எல்லாமே தீர்த்து வைப்பாய் பார்வை படுகின்ற சிவன் வடிவம் யாரும் பாரா இடமெல்லாம் முன்னோருவம் வேண்டும் மனதிற்குள் புகுந்தீர்ப்பாய் நித்யா வேண்டாதவர்களும் இறந்தீர்ப்பாய் தாண்டி குறுகின்ற மனமாடக்கில் உன்னை தாக்கி தொழுதாலே அரவணைப்பாய் விதிக்கும் விதியாய் இருப்பவனே விதிக்குள் இருக்கும் விளைவுகளே இருக்கும் கதியாய் இருப்பவனே கவலை உலகும் செக்கசிறந்திருக்கும் செங்கடியும் நீதான் சிந்தை குளிர வைக்கும் வெண்ணிலவு பிரபஞ்சம் எல்லாமே உன் சீருக்கு இந்த அண்டம் எல்லாமே உன் படைப்பு
ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம். ஐ பிளஸ் யூ ஆல். லெட்ஸ் ஆல் ரேடியேட் வித் இன்டெகிரிட்டி, ஆத்தென்டிசிட்டி, ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி, என்ரிச்சிங், காசிங், லிவிங் சுத்தாத்வைத சைவம். பரமசிவோஹம். ஓம் நித்யானந்த பரமசிவோஹம். எட்டர்னல் பிளிஸ் நித்யானந்த. தேங்க்யூ. பி பிளிஸ்ஃபுல்.